Praise is who I am.
Praise is who I am.
I will podcast. From the rising of the sun to the going down of the sun, his name alone is worthy to be praised. David said, oh, bless the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Oh, let's magnify the Lord. Praise is what I do. Can you say amen? Did you come to praise him?
Amen.
Did you come to give him glory?
Yes.
Did you come to magnify his name?
Yes.
Into the Bible says, into the gate with thanksgiving.
Yes.
And to his court with praise.
Yes.
Be thankful unto him and bless him. For the Lord is what?
Good.
And his mercy
endures
for all generations.
Yes.
He was good to my grandma.
Yes.
He was good to my great grandma.
Yes.
He was good to my mama.
Yes.
He's been good to me.
Yes.
Through all generations.
Yes.
The Lord is good.
Yes.
Hallelujah. I don't know what you come to do, but I come to give him praise.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
I want you to turn. We're going to be with you for a few moments. I want you to turn to this, to the book of Acts in the second chapter. We're going to read about 3-4 verses maybe. When we find it, we're going to ask you to stand. Acts chapter 2. Let's just read verses 1-4. Are you there yet?
Amen.
When the day of Pentecost had fully come, they were all with one accord in one place. And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind. And it filled the whole house where they were seated. Then there appeared to them divers tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each of them. And they were all filled with the Holy Spirit, and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. You may be seated in the house of the Lord. Let me ask this question. When you laid down to sleep last night, what was the first or the last thing that you did, or the last check you made? You made sure the door was locked. When you left to come to worship, before you got in your car and shut, well, when you shut the door and to go to your car, what was the last thing that you checked? You made sure that the door was locked. I want to use for a subject this morning. When we're locked in on God, Satan is locked out. When we're locked in on God, Satan is locked out. Somebody grab your keys, if you will. Grab your key just for a moment. Let's act this thing out for a moment. Satan's busy, but God's busier.
Yeah.
It's up to us to recognize what he is doing in our lives.
Yeah.
And begin to turn the key in the doors of our minds, in the doors of our thoughts, in the doors of our lives, in the doors of our situation to the locked position. If you will, turn it to the lock position and lock the devil out. When it comes to church, we should anticipate the move of the Holy Spirit. We're not hoping that God moves when we show up here. We know that God is going to move. Amen. We are in what? Expectation. God said, where two or three are gathered together in my name, I'm in the midst. I had this thought about when I prepared this message. I thought about this. What would folks do or think if they did like we did when COVID hit? when we showed up at church, passed out masks? What would churchgoers think when the attendant at the door began to hand them blindfold? And the order was given, put them on, take a seat, don't remove them till service is over. Where would your mind be if you had a blindfolder on in church? Your mind would be on anticipation. You wouldn't be focusing on your beans on the stove, your cornbread in the oven, or what so-and-so next to you was saying. You would be focusing on what God getting ready to do. Can you say amen? I make it a habit never to sit by folk in church who like to talk. Because that is a distraction. When you're preaching or people are preaching and you're sitting by somebody that's always punching you or commenting on what is said or what they heard, that is a distraction. And that's what the enemy is all about, is distracting us. He don't want us to hear God speak to us individually. So we have to lock him out. Lock him out of our minds. Lock him out of our thoughts. Lock him out of everything that is not associated with what God is doing. Notice God said it is a mind thing. He said they were all in one accord, touching and agreeing in what? One mind. On one accord. Amen. It brings on our thoughts that are not associated with God, brings on negativity. When you're sitting in the congregation and you're thinking on everything but the word that is delivered, it brings on negativity. Amen. So it'd be nice if we all had blinders on this morning. So we would sit there silently and quietly in anticipation. Amen. And when we do that, guess what? God's going to move.
Yes.
Amen. God's going to always do what God do.
Yes.
I tell you, it's good to be in the house of the Lord in anticipation.
Amen.
Expecting God to move. We should not sit and wonder if God's going to do a certain thing.
Yes.
Amen. I don't come to church and hope that God alleviates my situation. That he corrects my problem. That he fixes this and that. I come to church knowing that I'm a kingdom heir and that God is going to work, because his word said all things work together for the good of them that love the Lord, that are called according. I'm not the man at the gate called beautiful hoping somebody give me something. I am a kingdom heir. So when I show up here, I know God's going to bless me.
Yes.
Jesus said, destroy this temple.
Yes.
And in
the resurrection, catches up with them, asks them this question: why are you sad? Why are you talking? One of them said, are you a stranger? Don't you know what just happened? This man Jesus, they beat him all night long, took him from judgment hall to judgment hall, hung him on a cross, laid him in a tomb. But they forgot. He said, I'll get back up in 3 days. He began to converse with them and just wonder what he talked about, but it was good. And they said, won't you stay with us? Spend the night. Now Jesus pretty slick. He acted like he was going a little bit further, Tommy. They said, hey, stay with us a little while. So he stayed with them, began to have supper. And the Bible said he started breaking bread. And when he started breaking bread, immediately they knew who he was. And while they when they recognized him, supernaturally, the Bible said he disappeared. Spirit from heaven came in as a rush. I'm about done. Peter ain't the only one preached on the day of Pentecost. The Lord, other ones did too. Can I prove it? The Bible says, and they all, not just Peter, but they all spoke as the Spirit gave them the utterance or the ability to speak in the languages of those on the outside. So they were preaching to every nation in their own native language. Somebody said they drunk up in that. They done got high. But Peter with the Holy Ghost got boldness. And the Bible said he stood up in their midst. Somebody need to get him locked and loaded. Yeah. Tell the devil you're tired of him busting in on you. Yeah. Busting in on you with your problems. Yeah. Busting in on your situation. Yeah. Busting in on your physical condition. Yeah. Turn the lock.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Turn the lock. Yeah. Lock them fools out.
Yeah.
Get your hand in with. No good. Lock them friends out that say you love your friends but talk about you behind your back. Lock them out. When the damsel was sick and Jesus said this, she only sleep. The Bible said they laughed him. They liked God.
Yes.
When God said, she only sleep. So he took the mother a few more inside and took the brother, the parent, and a few more inside and went to the damsel and said, tell her come back.
Yes.
Spoke life into their dead body because all that negativity was.
Yes.
Don't let nobody tell you God ain't gonna do it.
Yes.
God ain't gonna heal you. God ain't gonna deliver you. Don't let them tell you that ain't gonna happen. Lock them out. Don't let them tell you you ain't nobody, you ain't nothing. Lock them out. That I carry around. That might be what's hurting my back. I got too many. Look at all them damn keys. And I don't use but a third of them. I need to clean up my key ring. But I don't need but one for the devil. The Son of Man must be turned over into the hands of him and be crucified. Peter said, not so, Lord. That ain't gonna happen. Jesus said, get thee behind me, Satan. He had to lock out that thought that Peter had. He wasn't addressing Peter. He was addressing the influence behind the saying, it ain't gonna happen. Jesus done said, is going. Everything negative that the enemy throws at me, thank you. Everything, I don't care what it is, Sister Trip, everything negative that Satan throws at me, guess what I do? Church playing basketball, get mocked by him. And he was being fancy, and all the little classmates at half court, and they all would do it to him, say, do it to him, do it to him, do it. And the more they hollered, the more he got fancy. And he would slam. And he'd say to Mark Packer, in your face. That's what we need to tell the devil, in your face. Somebody put that away somewhere.
Yeah.
Lock mode.
Yeah.
When you're in trouble,
yeah,
let your mind think on lock mode.
Yeah.
When you're depressed,
lock
let your mind think on lock mode. When you're sad, let your mind think on lock mode. When you nobody and no one rain on my parade. Don't care what you say, what you're talking about, how you feel about, you're not gonna rain on my parade, because guess what? I know scripture. The scripture says rejoice. Always again I say. When it's good, when it's bad, when it's sad, the word of God says,
rejoice.
What God is blessing you with. He blessed us with what? Peace.
Yes.
The peace I give you. That's what Jesus taught me.
Yes.
Not as the world give you, but as I give you.
Yes.
This peace will surpass. It'll go plumb past your understanding.
Yes.
You won't even be able to figure out why you're feeling so good at such a bad time.
Yes.
Children be acting a fool.
Yes.
Homeless be acting a fool. Why are you be acting a fool? But you in peace.
Yes.
You broke. Outside. Outside. Interference. Sister Johnson, you ain't gonna come at 531 North Wilder Avenue, Rockwood, Tennessee, and sit down in my house and make me sad. This is my castle. This is what God gave me. And you ain't gonna come in here and depress me, because this is what God has blessed. Just think about God rather than what they're dealing with. So what if the car notes do? So what if the house note is behind? Out of nowhere. Ain't that what the older folks say? He'll make a way out of it. Little woman had nothing but a little bit of meal. One little cake during the famine for her and her son.
Yeah.
We're going to eat what?
Yeah.
Y'all know the word up in here.
Yeah.
But the miracle. God said, make me one first. She done already said, we ain't got nothing to make but one. But the man of God said, make me one. Make me a cake first. And so she got stopped thinking about dying. She stopped thinking about not having nothing. She stopped thinking about the depression and the famine. She went to work, fired up the stove, put the wood in the coal, got the meal out the cup, poured a little water in the cup, stirred it up, put it on 350, gave it time to rise and bake. Then she took it out of the stove, handed it to the man of God, and the Bible said,
you up. Coming around the curve. Isn't that right? Little girl, move your yesterday. Her music was so loud, it was thumping in my heart. You got to turn, pump it up now and tell the devil, I know a better day is coming. You got to pump it up. We're too conservative in the church. Oh, we don't want to get too loud.